So then let me ask you this, because I've studied the yogis from India for a long time, and it seems that when they find enlightenment, and there are other ascended masters too, but when they find this enlightenment or this other reality that they go to, they've talked about it. They're yeah. able to start to transcend these quote unquote magical powers where they can levitate or they can biolocate or things like that, you know, manifest in their hands with stuff, heal and so on. What are they accessing to allow them to have these kind of, I'm not that concerned with the abilities. That's kind of like a parlor trick on, or like an afterthought, but more on the spiritual side, what are they accessing to reach those higher levels of awareness and understanding in the world where, like in the Maharishi, they gave him a whole bunch of, you know, psychedelic mushrooms and he ate them and he's just like, I live here. I don't need these.
That's home. Yeah. When I first took ayahuasca, I actually, my first feeling was like, oh, home.
Aubrey told me that our friend Aubrey Marcus, he's like, it's this craziest thing doing ayahuasca with Matias. So what is it with these yogis that they reach? What are they doing? What are they accessing to get this kind of awareness or information?
Well, you become it. And that's enlightenment. When they reach enlightenment, actually, it's because they weren't looking for enlightenment. All the traditions of the Hinduism, Buddhism, it's not about, it's not like, for example, our traditions that are looking for salvation, or they are expecting for someone to take them out of this reality. They actually sit down and become part of this reality so deep that eventually they find enlightenment. So basically it's like, why can't you do fire? Because that person became the fire, not because it can has the power of fire. That's our point of view, because we think that humans are here to handle reality and everything was created for us to manage it or whatever. But the person that actually finds enlightenment is because they became the fire, they became the water, they became God. They found themselves through every dimension, and they saw that the potentialities of all reality are basically themselves. It's us. So you are an echo of all that. And that's what they are connecting with. They are connecting with what you actually are, which is everything. Beyond your personality, beyond what you are looking for, you just become. And that's why every master, when you go to the very deep of everything, the only thing that you can say is, I am. Because there's nothing else.
Because you are. So it's not a destination, which is a misconception. It's like, oh, I have to find enlightenment. Like that's like a room you walk into, like, thank God I found enlightenment. It's not that. Yes. It's more like you become kind of like Neo becoming part of the Matrix.
Exactly.
He literally absorbs into the code, and he is then, as opposed to being just outside of it and understanding it and seeing it and manipulating it, he becomes one with it. So that's where these yogis, when they go into meditation, they're there and they come back by choice to teach the rest of us as much as they can.
Yeah. But the thing is that we have still this perception of they went there.
Right. But
but actually they went nowhere. Like they actually became what it really is. So they went nowhere. They were just sitting there. Right. And suddenly the skin, the cells became the air, and the air became the skin, and the cells became molecules, and the molecules are energy. And suddenly there's nowhere to go. You become everything. So It's not about, that's why the last position of the enlightened person is not someone touching the light. It's someone just sitting down on the tree.
Because they are the light. because they are the light.
Because you are the light.
To watch the full video, click on the link below. And don't forget to subscribe.